What is Barnes and Bostock? Further, you have a definition here. Okay, if you need, you can take a screenshot. Then come to the next one, virus resistant plants. So virus resistant plants, we know that mostly crops are affected by insects or worms, and most of the diseases are caused by virus. Okay, so viral disease which affects the shoot part, fruits, and as well as root part. Okay, without in certain cases only it affects the middle of the shoot, but basically it affects the tip of a shoot and root part. So root rotting, shoot rotting may be occurs because of a viral disease. Okay, and slowly it leads to the death of the plants. So by using RDNA technology, covers naturally to the plant. Suppose if the virus starts to affect the plant, now that won't cause any diseases to the plant items. So for that, they are developing disease viral resistant plants in a crop items. So what are the crop items they are developing? Viral resistant crop items. Now mostly they were developed the tobacco plants, because we know that like a cotton, it's a cash crop. So to give a resistant power against virus, they are developing virus resistant plants. Okay. So how they are developing viral resistant plants? Once the virus enters into the crops, now that DNA particles of the virus are deactivated or destroyed by the plant genes. Okay. So likewise, they are developing a immunity power in the plant species, like a crop items, like a tobaccos. Okay. So for that, the first example is given. Sorry, this is another one, flavor saver tomatoes. So tomatoes also affected by virus. So in tomatoes, we can see a root rotting as well as fruit rotting because of a viral disease. So viral resistant disease is a three-mark question, separate question. And the second one, next one is flavor saver tomatoes. Okay. Suppose if our mother bought some fruits, tomato fruits, and she tried to store for a longer time, now we cannot store. The reason we know that. So if you are taking after 1 week, if you are taking the tomato fruit, now we can see the bottom may be over ripen, and from the wound we will get a juice. Okay, the juice starts to come out because of the storage. Okay, so for storing the tomato fruits longer time, and to maintain the solid state of a tomato fruit, we are creating a transgenic tomatoes. The transgenic tomatoes are called as a flavor saver tomatoes. Okay, so this transgenic flavor saver tomatoes were created by using an organism called Agrobacterium tumefaciens. We know that it's a soil living bacteria. Okay. So same way, how we are producing RDNA, you know, isolation of a plasmid and removal of a tumor-inducing gene. So in that gap, we will insert a gene for maintaining the aroma of a fruit, and for maintaining the solid state of a fruit, we will insert a gene. Yes? Okay. So for maintaining the color and to maintain the flavor of tomatoes, we are introducing a transgenic plants. Okay. So then next, we will follow the genetic engineering step. That genetic engineering step, which is used for the slow ripening of tomatoes. Okay. So after collecting the fruits from the plant, if you are keeping in the open vessel, nalo, in the very next day morning, we can see the fully ripened tomato fruits. Okay. So that shows very fast ripening process. So to slow down the ripening process and to increase the flavor and to maintain the solid state of a fruit, they are developing a flavor saver tomatoes. Okay. And come to the next one, resistant to rotting. So these kind of flavor saver tomatoes are resistant to rotting. So here you can see the rotting. Rotting, it develop a block color spots, and after over rotting, which starts to bring out all the juices of a fruit, tomato fruit. Okay, so that is the rotting process, which was stopped by introduction of a gene from Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Okay, and come to the next one. And along with the RDNA of Agrobacterium, they are inserting, okay, antisense polygalacturonase. So what is polygalacturonase? So which is used or which is the enzyme used in the ripening of our tomatoes. It is naturally available in the tomato fruits that helps in the ripening of a fruit. Once the unripened tomato fruit, it starts to secrete polygalactone, it will become a ripened tomato. Okay, so along with the RDNA of agrobacterium, they are inserting antisense. Antisense means which gives slow ripening process. Okay, ripening will be done in a slow manner. So antisense ripening gene, that is polygalactonase gene, is inserted along with the agrobacterium RDNA that helps in delaying the ripening of a tomato fruits. Okay, and suppose ripening of a tomato is delayed, now we can store the tomato's fruits for a longer time, and we can transport the tomatoes from our state to far states like Delhi. Kuda nam enna pannalam fruits transport pannalam, because and the traveling duration is more. So on that duration la the fruit vand ripen agama ketu pogama irukkadhukaga they are using this polygalactonase along with the agrobacterium RDNA.